1968, manager Don Revie and his Leeds team broke new ground by winning the club's first major trophy.
Arsenal kick off in the second League Cup final to be held at Wembley. Arsenal with seven league championships to their credit against Leeds. Leeds have already been so near to winning the League Cup, as well as the FA and the Fairs Cups as well. Arsenal's John Radford, 7, and David Jenkins, 8, soon to be frustrated. Up to now, frustration has played a major part in the Leeds story. But for skipper Billy Bremner, passing here to Cooper, the frustration will soon be over. The goal that's going to make Don Revie the happiest man in the North is due any moment now. Then a corner taken by Gray, it's headed out but straight to Cooper, who put it hard and fast into the back of Fernell's net. Radford and Jenkins again as Arsenal try to live up to their record. Then a corner taken by Jenkins. McClintock barges into goalie's break, and Leeds suggests it's not a very nice way to behave, whatever the score.
Vendettas going on right from the first kick of the ball, and it was a nothing game, and really no team really deserves to win it, but the reason we won it was because it was only a spectacular goal. I can remember that distinctly. It was Coops, it was a free, it would have been a free kick nowadays, to be fair. The Arsenal players and Frank McClintock and Ian Muir and all them were screaming at the referee, and as I say, is that if it had been the same situation, if someone had barged into Gary Sprake at that particular instant, we would have been all round the referee, because it really should have been a free kick.
So Leeds are still one goal up at the interval, and they stay that way in spite of all Arsenal's attempts. Indifferent in many ways as a match, all its failings were forgiven at least by Leeds supporters as Bremner and his men triumphantly show the trophy.
There was a couple of ugly incidents on that. I don't think anybody looking back on it really relishes looking at it again. But that shows you how competitive the game was in order. But the second half, like you say, there was an incident with Gary, and I think he followed through as Gary came out with the ball and started a wee skirmish again and that. But that was part and parcel of the game. It was always going to be a very difficult game. There was always, no matter if you're one up, you're still walking the tightrope. You're dying for a referee, you blow his whistle. And when he eventually did, I think it was a great relief for everybody concerned, because it was, besides we had won the second division championship, but it was really the first major honour that the club had won, and we were delighted that we were part of the history of the club at that particular time.
And that was that. It was all over. Leeds had won by a disputed goal. There's a bottle of logic with a result. But nobody complains of a great match, even though at least one fan got carried away in his efforts to congratulate the cup winners. Still, the League Cup was on its way home to Leeds, the first major prize for a Yorkshire side in 33 years.